City over to 13 County, but you're still south of the front down there across the southern outer banks, so this is ahead of it. Lots of rain showers falling around Manio. You got more rain in here, Elizabeth City, back to Ahoskie. Some of these rain showers kind of drop south there a little bit. That's the front around Coleraine in 13 County right now. That is dropping southward. So we go up to the south side, we've got a lot of rain over Suffolk, Chesapeake, Portsmouth. All this is pushing into Norfolk. The Norfolk Naval Base getting the rain back. And Virginia Beach, you're starting to get the wider area of rain again. Chesapeake showers down by now, but all this is coming out of Chesapeake. Through Smithfield, Newport News, lots of rain. Hampton, Potosi, York County.
Andre's death was indeed unfortunate, but he did lay the groundwork for huge profits with the acquisition of that machine. I fully intend to honor his memory by building on that. Oh, you won't be disappointed, Mr. Shin. I promise you that. Very well.
She needed for the final load to be amped up exactly what she's thinking about the opportunity to do just that.
So easy to grip, makes it a very fair competition. Everson caught out now as Riska Mattihapula and Oscar Svensson pull away. Svensson looking wobbly leg on that corner, maybe a little more tired than I was giving him credit for earlier. But look at Svensson and Hakkala. Svensson almost punches Hakkala as Hakkala almost cuts him off. This guy's got to be careful. Hakkala did this in the quarterfinals too, and Bolshinov got a little angry with him. But Hakkala with the best fitness of this group, there's no doubt about it. Can he finish better than fourth? He's going to move on to the final, barring anything crazy happening on the finishing stretch. But here's what I'm talking about.
At the pole.
Spot this final, how much she's got left.
That's what I'm worried about. think that she's the fiercest fighter of
for the men's spring classic final. And we wonder whether Johannes Klebo is going to get the coronation that everybody predicted for him at these Olympic Games. Or if someone there, the other five, that are a little tired of all the attention that he's been getting.
Based on what I've seen tonight, I think we're going to get what we came to see. I think Klebo has got another gear. I think everybody else is going to be chasing, and in the last kilometer, I think he'll open it up. I could be wrong, but I don't think I am.
He's got that amazing style of power. He's got the matinee idol looks, and he is a big deal in Norway.
He's got a country to deal with as well. And Paul Bulver, the lovely qualifier, the worst qualifier in this group. And Federico Pellegrino, if anybody can do it, I think Pellegrino looks really good on that climb in the semifinal on the big climb.
Oh, we're going headless.
That's, he's making a statement. Doesn't need to stay warm. Ristamonte Hakala clearly has good fitness.
But we're going to check your theory.
Well, I think he just used too much energy to beat Klebo. And then he's also been very dangerous, almost fallen both times in the quarters and the semis. And that set of tracks right before the stadium at the bottom of the downhill. And I gotta say, Oscar Svensson, a bit of a dark horse. I think he looks good, doesn't he? You got a 21-year-old, two 21-year-olds, and a 22-year-old in here.
Right, so he's making a conscious decision not to go with the hat. Why?
Good question. It's
not cold?
It's minus 9 degrees Celsius at the start. Not sure it's probably cooled off since then. But he's going to have to back that decision up with some skiing, that's for sure. Federico Pellegrino, probably the best chance to match the speed, the upright speed that Klebo possesses. And gritty worker, Bolshinov, 21 years of age, just a beast. I just don't think he's got the finishing speed to challenge Klebo, and probably not Pellegrino either. Skiathlon to beat the Klebo, you have to go fast and take something out of him if you can. He's had all night, but it might be a little too late. Washing off in Klebo, there's the Klebo run. And as these Olympic Games began, the climb we're going to see after this climb has already been dubbed Klebo Bakken, which means Klebo Hill. Everybody talked about that. That's where he will likely win his medals. And we're going to see it at the bottom of this hill. Pellegrino's got to get in position to match it and not let Klebo get away on this, what's being called Klebo Bakken. Klebo skis are good. He's right on the tail of Bolshinov, and he moves inside. And here we go. Can anybody match this? I don't think so. Bolshinov is trying. Pellegrino is chasing. Bolshinov doing a pretty good job of it, though. Klebo is being challenged. But can he get the gap here? This is where he's so good. Top of the hill, over the top. There's the gap. He's gone. Like a cannon. Klebo is over the top and has a huge lead already. Finding the seconds where everybody has to rest. Now it's a race for silver.
Wow, that was impressive.
I think that hill just earned its name.
I tell you, the first time I saw a Norwegian skier, he was in the woods. I called him the Terminator. He looked like a man who just chewed up mountains, and that was Vegard Ulvang. And then Kurt Gale looked better than him, and you wonder what plus he is.
They weren't even sprinting back then. In the silver medal position ahead of the speedy Pellegrino. Does Pellegrino have the turnover to get him in the final 100? He takes a little bit of a rest to give it one more shot, but Klebo is gone.
Bolshinov wants to try and salvage a silver out of this. Pellegrino just sat back and watched those two guys duel. Does it give him enough to claim silver? He's there right now.
Pellegrino! Great work from Pellegrino! Bolshinov.
new king of cross-country skiing delivers without really any problem.
While the most decorated cross-country Olympian of all time, Bjorn Dahle, said of his young countryman, quote, he has a speed and a technique that I've never seen before. He's a unique guy. And now, Johannes Hersbrock-Klebo has an Olympic gold medal. When we come back, we take a look at the recent history of both North and South Korea with NBC News tomorrow.
Symptom.